Okay, my topic is a study to evaluate the toxicity and ecological impact of determining metal concentration in surface water around the Sabarmati River in Gujarat. It is only basically in an ICP-MS study. Okay, the first part is the introduction. Then I finally introduce the introduction about the Sabarmati River. Sabarmati is the one of the most river in the western region of India. It is a monsoon-fed river that originate in the Arvali hills of Rajasthan. This is the image I can collect in the Google map. This is the Sabarmati basin divided in a two part. First basin is the Rajasthan in a Rajasthan district. This is the Sabarmati basin images. This is divided in a two parts. One is Rajasthan and one is the Gujarat. So basically, Sabarmati River is starting in the Arvali hills of Rajasthan, then finally passing into the Gujarat basin. So passing into Gujarat basin finally is the meet to the Gulf of Cambay. So first of all, why I am choosing this topic, the reason behind of to check water quality of metal of the Sabarmati River. The reason behind the heavy metal checking of Sabarmati River is the unchecked flow of untreated industrial influent in the river in Gujarat has led to increased pollution in the Sabarmati, Mahisagar, Narmada, most of the rivers in Gujarat. But according to data from the Ministry of Environment and Forest, the Sabarmati River is among the most polluted river in the country. It is the data in June 6, 2021. So we are going to test the result data of Ahmedabad and especially Gujarat basin. So Gandhinagar and Ahmedabad are important urban centers in this basin. Ahmedabad is an industrial city situated on the banks of Sabarmati. Important industries are textile industry, leather goods, plastics, and many more industries are there. Okay, then my objective of this study is to evaluate of water quality trends over a time of Sabarmati River. Day by day or month by month, the heavy metal concentration quality of water is decreased or increased. Then the second is to determine the heavy metal concentration of water by ICP-MS. It's inductive copper plasma mass spectroscopy. The third is to determine if existing pollution control measures are really effective. They are doing their measurement properly or improperly, like false or true. Then understanding the environment fate of various pollutants. Like if the metal is in future more concentrated or more toxic, then what kind of disease develop in human beings, animals, or ecosystems? And my last objective of this topic is for the evolution of water suitability to the different uses. This concentration of metallic water is very high, then not suitable for the drinking. So the suitability part is there because the water is not suitable, then we immediately have to avoid to drink. But if the concentration is suitable for the household use, then we use that much only. Okay, this is my second chart of the material. The material is the Sabarmati River water samples. Water samples were collected in 1 liter new PE water. Samples were collected from January to December of 2020. Water samples were collected from 7 different locations along the river's course in order to get a good idea of the extent of trace metal contamination. 7 sampling sites were chosen, which received waste from various point and non-point sources, including municipality and domestic waste. Then the acidity by this water, with HNO3 and send it to the further analysis. This is basically my diagram table, how I can collect the sample. The site number one is Raisangam. I more describe about that. Raisangam, that first of all I say that Sabarmati River is starting from the Arvali hills of Rajasthan, then it will passes to the Gujarat state, right? Then the finally Ahmedabad and Gandhinagar areas basin. First, we can check the flow of the water of Sabarmati. This is first the Raisangam. Then we can collect you the sample one by one in this last at 7 different locations. The first is in Raisangam, then Karaikam. It is a 2 location site of Gandhinagar Tehsil. Then the third is Indira Bridge. It's the located in Hasolkam. Then fourth is the Vasna Barrage. The Vasna Barrage in the Fatehwadi Canal. It is the main canal divert water from the villages, towns of the south and southwest of Ahmedabad. Then the fourth collection site is Naro to Visala Highway Road. It is basically known as the Shastri Base. It is the main industrial and wastewater dumping site of Ahmedabad. And the industry literally putting down their leaches, rake and all dumping site in the Sabarmati rivers. Then the sixth is the Kasindra Dam. Kasindra village is located in a district textil of Ahmedabad. Then finally, we can go to the Pautha Dam. Pautha is the village of Dholka Taluka in Ahmedabad district. It is the final point where the Sabarmati flow runs. Then the Sabarmati River in the Pautha, we already know the name 7 Sangams. So in a Vautha Sabarmati plus with the instrumentation, stress metal in the water sample were determined using methodology in a part. Stress metal in the water sample were determined using ICP-MS. This is the model number of ICP-MS. The main principle of ICP-MS is why we can choose ICP-MS study for the heavy metal. So the principle of a heavy ICP-MS is the ICP-MS is an atomic emission technique related to the flame photometry. Except that the atom and ions present in the sample are excited in a very high temperature gas plasma. The plasma provide very high temperature and hence the energy. Almost all the atom present in the sample can excite it with the technique ending up with the high efficiency, right? And thus, the emission from the atom would be more intense and even every small concentration of metal ion can be detected and accurately measured. This is the main principle of ICP-MS study. And this is normal setting up for the final analysis of this sample, pumping size and all the parameters is this. Finally, this is my collecting finding analysis data. How I can get a heavy metal concentration of different sizes. You can show the concentration in mg per liter, but you can show that when the sample one side in a Gandhinagar district, the sample every metal sample concentration is very low. But when the flow is passes on the this in this ways, the concentration of more metals are very high and the more metals are very decreasing. This is why the reason I was selected this way flow. This is my 21 metals data. And finally, I got in conclusion that as a result of the present study, water quality at 7 site of Sabarmati river seem not acceptable by most of the hydrological analysis parameter and instrumental findings also. Many more metal toxicity were very high to induce toxicity like this Zn, Mg, copper and etc. So I conclude that many diseases have been already reported in the livestock like Chakri, Opri and Kul Sutra during the result of heavy metal polluted water. And also in a human being, high toxicity of metal is harmful to create genotoxicity in human and also produce ecotoxicity effect in the atmosphere. In this paper, he was first studying HTC cells, and recently I am studying in a Hepsi-2 cell, how can the Sabarmati Pirana Dam and all the area of Ahmedabad water can contaminate water can how can produce genotoxicity. Recently I am working on a Hepsi-2 cells, hepatocarcinoma cells. This is the liver cells, and these cell lines I have to put the Sabarmati river in vitro culture to the labs, and then got a more excited or more very true result. Thank you.